Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here with one of the greatest preachers and historians and theologians of this generation, Thomas Weisser, Brother Tom Weisser. He has written so many books. He's friends. He goes and teaches in Europe every year. He's friends with like the librarian at Oxford. He says, call him up and say, Tom, we have something you might be interested in. And just going back to apostolic truth throughout the centuries. So this is rare writings from the 17th, 19th century compiled by Tom Weisser. And we'll just go through some of this because it is very fascinating. Incredible stuff to read. And some of the names you're going to recognize, but there's always been a church. One of Tom's great convictions is the gates of hell cannot prevail against the church. So God didn't lose his Bible and found it later, and he didn't lose his church and find it at Azusa Street or the Arroyo Seco camp meeting. He's always had a church, and he's always had a Bible. So the beginning corner, the restoration of the gospel, 1876. Now, see, this would be about the time of Miller. Miller was a Presbyterian minister, but he talked about the oneness of God. As a matter of fact, the Pentecostal Publishing House used to publish his book. Okay, an article about D.L. Moody's rejection of Acts 2:38 found in the Christian Standard, April 3rd, 1897. Now, the Christian church with Barton Stone, Alexander Campbell, they had a lot of non-Trinitarians in Acts 2:38 people. As a matter of fact, from that movement, you can read about Mary Todd Lincoln's family getting baptized in Jesus' name. That's a fascinating thing, such as Abraham Lincoln's wife, and a great chance Abraham Lincoln's wife, Mary Todd Lincoln, was baptized in Jesus' name. A short work entitled, Why Socinianism? Why Athanasianism? Why Not Apostolical Christianity? In 1838. And this is something that I want to do a review on separately, part of William Penn's The Sandy Foundation Shaken and William Penn's Intimacy with Her Open Face, 1668. A lot of people don't know William Penn, whom the state of Pennsylvania is named after, was a big oneness proponent, as was almost every Quaker before 1700. They had a oneness view of Jesus Christ and a oneness view of God. And a lot of people say, well, William Penn did not baptize in Jesus' name. But the person who wrote After the Way Called Heresy, Our Roots, Delroy Gale, he's got a great quote by William Penn about Romans 6:4, where it sure seems to indicate he baptized in Jesus' name. So there's a state named after Oneness Pentecostal. And actually, the first four people to die here in America for religious reasons were Oneness people, Mary Dyer and William Ledra and Marmaduke Stevens and the other there in Boston Commons. They hung them because they didn't believe in the Trinity. They believed in the deity of Jesus Christ. They believed God's Father, Son, Holy Ghost, but they wouldn't say the word Trinity or persons, didn't believe in that, and they got hung. So, most of a book entitled A Discourse Concerning the Nominal and Real Trinitarians. There was a big move amongst the General Baptist and particular Baptist in the late 1600s because of the widespreadness of the King James being so transparent with the originals that they believed the oneness. And then Robert Robinson, who wrote Ecclesiastical Researches and A History of Baptism, where he shows between 600 and the 800s AD that Jesus' name baptism was all over the place, especially in Spain. He went and researched the monasteries, the convents, and the provincial records and saw people baptized in Jesus' name, mainly the Paulinians, Paulicinians, and on and on. And that would match up with the Priscillians. Priscillian was bishop in Spain and that was killed in the 390s. Because people, you'll be hated of all people for his namesake, Jesus. Jesus is the radical thing. Hallelujah. So Robert Robertson's plea for the divinity of our Lord Jesus Christ. So phenomenal book. You want to get your hands on this. Google it. Get it. You will love it. It defends the faith and tremendous book. God bless you. I'll talk with you later in Jesus' name.